So I think having an environment where we can actually go out that more closely models, or as much as we can, an actual client's home, anything that tries to reach for actual real life situations is obviously going to be beneficial to people that are training.
I've been hoping to put something together like this for about 7 years, starting with some interest in how students basically are trained in undergrad and grad to prepare themselves for work in child welfare, child protection. And so UIS started looking at a curriculum as a way to better prepare students and get them prepared in a way that when they get in the field, they're not overwhelmed by the reality of the work that they're doing. And if we can graduate them with this type of skill and understanding and a sense of what they're likely to encounter in the field, the turnover is reduced in child welfare.
It is the way to go because it gives now workers, and not just workers, but a lot of departments, the opportunity to one, work together collaboratively, which is the way that's going on right now in a lot of cities, small and large, of bringing resources together because it's so limited. How can we work smarter together? It also gives a new and more enhanced experience in terms of training, away from your typical didactic classroom training, instead of really getting people in there to learn not only about the different techniques, but also learn something about themselves and how they can improve. And in the end, the ultimate goal is to do more effective investigations and, more importantly, make sure children are protected and families are supported.
Until this new residential simulation lab came along, we had no way to really do practical experience. The one thing that is probably the most unnerving, and especially as new investigators, is the fact that that first knock on the door, you don't know what's behind it. You're meeting total strangers, and until you get that experience, I can't teach you that.
You know, you actually get that engagement with the client going up to the door, trying to get into the home, having it be a house. There's other things you can, you know, because when you go out to do investigations, you're obviously looking for more than just the things that they're telling you. So you can gauge the environment, you can take a look around and see if there are other issues that you need to address, like drug or alcohol issues, signs of domestic violence, things of that nature that you would want to pick up on and then be able to sort of carry the interview forward with the client about.
I spent my career as a prosecutor, and I just see tremendous value for this kind of training in making DCFS investigators, law enforcement, whoever, more capable of both gathering the information about a situation and responding to it, but also for court purposes. We can't prosecute a case, whether that's in child protection court, in juvenile court, or in criminal court, if we don't have a solid investigation. And this, I think, would just go so far in improving the quality of those investigations.
It's amazing to watch how you forget that they're not real family members and they're not real investigators doing this simulation in the house. So this house on our campus is sort of an amazing gift that over the years it wasn't just torn down or, you know, used for something else. It's just been sitting there, and we're one of the first campuses to work in partnership with DCFS in this training endeavor. And for that, I'm really grateful for the administration, the support, and all of the staff that have come together, the technology folks, the faculty, everyone who could see this vision. And today it kind of came to life.